Hi everybody and welcome back to Calm Your Dog. Now for today's video, me and a very, very sleepy Miley here, we're going to be talking about how to get your dog to trust you. Now whether you're introducing a new dog into the house or you could be like moving in somewhere and they've got a dog, or you could just want to learn a bit more how to make a dog trust you and what are the sort of the top things you need to be doing, then this video is perfect for you. Before we do get started though, please let me know down below in the comments, what is your relationship like with your dog? Do you feel like you have a really trustworthy relationship? Is it something that you're working on? Please do let us know down below in the comments. One of the main things that you need to do if you're wanting to build that trustful relationship with your dog is to stay calm around your dog. You'd be surprised how much a dog appreciates that. If you are always here, there and everywhere, panicking all the time around your dog, it's going to get them quite wound up and anxious as well. Whereas if you are quite calm around them, they'll know that, I mean, look at Milo right now. He is completely out for the count. He knows that he can trust me by just sleeping there. So it may be quite tempting to greet your dog with excited energy, but try and avoid that temptation. If you approach your dog in an excited state, it can make the dog excited and lead it to an unwanted greeting, like it jumping on you. It can also trigger a dog's fight or a fight or flight instinct if a stranger with high energy approaches. Obviously, if your dog's not ready for that and they're a bit shocked by that, you don't really know what the response is going to be like. So just trying to stay calm, whether you're introducing yourself to a new dog or whether you have a dog yourself, you'll notice that they'll really appreciate that sort of energy. The next one is to obviously respect their space as well. So practice no touch, no talk, no eye contact. If you're asking a stranger whether you can greet their dog, touch the human and ignore the animal. Also avoid standing too close to the dog. Try to leave at least 4 feet between you before giving permission or getting permission to approach. This is a great way as well, just for you, if you're ever walking down the street and you realise that a dog's there and you want to go and approach it, make sure you take it cautiously because you don't know how that dog is going to behave. Again, we went out earlier and there was a little, I think it was like a Jack Russell mixed with something else, and just people were trying to approach this dog and it was not wanting to be stroked or to be talked to or anything like that. He got quite agitated. So if you're in that position, try and, like I say, talk to the owner before you then start approaching the dog, and the owner might not even want you to approach the dog, so just be aware of that as well. Another good way as well is to get on their level. Whenever you do approach a dog, do so from the side and never from the front. Kneel down next to the dog, facing the same direction. You're now in the dog's personal space, but in a non-confrontational way. Hold your hand down in a fist, still not making eye contact, and then obviously let them come to you and let them warm to you that way. This is a great way as well because you're getting on that level of with the dog, so that there's no hierarchy in this new relationship that you're just about to create with this dog. So again, just be aware of that. And that is it for this week's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Now this week's shout out goes to somebody that commented on my last vlog, which is when I spoke about how to give your dog the best life, and this was from a YouTube channel called Rick Temple, I think it is, and they said, for my dog, his best life is to sleep on the couch and next to me and move as little as possible. He doesn't like going on a walk and he's the laziest dog on the planet, which I love that. I mean, Milo looks pretty lazy right now, but he's actually quite an energetic dog, but we've just been out for an extra long walk this morning, so he is pretty shattered. But I love those dogs. I see so many videos of people like trying to get the dog ready to go for a walk, like saying all the favourite words, and they just want to just sleep on the sofa the whole time. I absolutely love that. I think it's so, so cute. But sometimes I guess you kind of want them to be a little bit more energetic and be ready for a walk, because you've thought about it or you've got more prepped for it. But yes, that is it for this week's video. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Also, don't forget to comment, and also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already and you would like to. And me and Milo will see you next week for next week's video. Bye.